坚持弹到，十级考出来，老二弹了四五年，老三弹了我不知道有没有两个月哈，就放弃了。我记得凯文说他从六年级开始，他就跟他妈妈说我非常非常喜欢数学，然后他六年级是不是钢琴就不弹了？几年你不弹钢琴的？六年级就不。六年就不谈了，但是他就很非常 focus 在数学上。他妈妈也跟我讲说，所有的 summer camp 都是 Kevin 自己找，因为我们在 Limburg 还有在 Miller 呢，非常非常好的一个环境，同学之间互相 support， 父母也互相 support。我们中国人、亚裔人那个有一个很不好的一个竞争的一个习惯哈，什么东西我跟谁去上学，我在那做什么，都要掖着藏着，因为我们增加一个。你知道我们大家一起竞争，特别在一个高中是大家同一个高中，我们就竞争对手。我为什么要把这个 information 告诉你？其实当你对别人遮遮盖盖，你当没给别人去隐藏东西，或者是讲一些假的 information 的时候，其实也在对自己其实没有一个好处的。因为我知道有的学校就是非常的不好，就是父母之间互相隐瞒哈，有什么东西在挖，要去挖别人的 information， 挖说哎呦这个小孩在哪里补习啊？在哪里做呀？但是 Limburg， 我们自己家孩子都是在 Limburg， 我非常非常喜欢那里那个一个环境，大家互相的 support。我知道那个Kevin 他自己在我们那边，你看他十二年级，在我们那边有教了三门课哈，现在 Amy 的课他在教，但是他跟我讲，他说 Sherry， 星期六下午和星期六晚上不要给我安排任何事情，因为我这个时间是给我的数学 club 的。因为他要 support， 他的数学在 Limburg 是非常好的 top 的，但是他说我这段时间是一定只给我的 club， 是要帮助他 club 的学生的。那他的妈妈跟别的父母哈也都是很敞开的，有什么 information 都会来分享的，因为他妈至少都分享给我了很多，对我们也非常非常大的一个支持。这个妈妈不是虎妈也不是羊妈，是一个鹰妈。我们能不能，这个妈妈这会很害羞哈。Kevin， 要不要你来请你妈妈感谢一下你的妈妈？我们请这个英妈能够站起来给大家看，给她一个鼓掌好吗？所以我们其实我是讲的外边那个大标题上是，写的是，我会分享怎么样做鹰妈，而不是虎妈和羊妈。我们中国人，我们前年的那个虎妈哈一写，大家都很，其实大家都在暗地里偷偷的在做虎妈，但是每个人说你是让谁承认谁是虎妈，没有一个人承认的。虎妈是什么？因为大家都不愿意承认，我要强加给我孩子什么什么什么什么东西，我要跟我孩子说，你考个 B， 我不能看见。只能是 A， 而且只能是 A+。你那个同学生，人家做了什么课外活动，参加了什么竞赛，你也必须去做。我就听说我有一个朋友，他就跟我说，我的一个朋友，他们家的孩子读了 Harvard， 他们走了什么路，上了什么课，参加了什么课外活动，我的孩子就要一个 exactly copy 下来。那我问他一句，我说你的孩子跟他是一样的兴趣吗？他说不知道。好了，我们现在这个。时间交给 Amanda 哈。
Hi everyone, I'm Amanda, and like Jennifer, I'm also a senior from Saratoga High School. So I'm going to share some of my thoughts about time management and how important it is in high school. And I'm also going to share some, just a little bit about parenting and like relationships with your parents. But I'll start with time management. So, Time management is pretty much one of the most important life skills you need, because when you're in high school, high school is when you start learning how to manage your time, because you have, first of all, you have schoolwork, and then you have extracurriculars and sports, and you probably also have family obligations to balance your time with, and sleep is also really important. But what's funny is, even though sleep is probably the most important of everything you need to balance in your life, it's also the first one that we forego when we're overworked. So it's pretty obvious that we forego sleep because it happens to be the easiest to forego. But the problem is, it's the easiest to forego, but it's also the most important. So it may seem obvious that the way to fix this problem is just to recognize what's important, but people don't always focus on what's important. So the secret here is when you're managing your time in high school, you just have to, like, you can recognize what's important, but at the same time, you won't always listen to yourself, and you won't always actually focus on what's important. So I think the key here is just to listen to yourself when you're tired or when you know that you need to sacrifice some work to get other more important work done. Okay. And high school is especially important because high school is when you have the freedom to experiment with like different kinds of schedules and finding out what kind of studying works best for you. And for me, I found that the way to get all my work done was just to wake up early sometimes and go to bed early because I function best in the morning. And, this slide isn't very important, but the point is, you have to find what kind of sleep schedule works the best for you. And for some people, I know that they stay up late to finish all their homework, and I guess that's what works best for them. But I feel that schedule worked for me, but I felt like the reason why I finished my homework when I stayed up late was because it was out of urgency. Whereas if I wake up early, then I feel like I have, I guess, the luxury of, because when you wake up in the morning to do homework, everything goes really smoothly and you learn things and you remember things better. But when you stay up late at night, you tend to forget whatever you learn at night from studying. So that's from my experience. And as for relationships with your parents, I see this with a lot of my friends, but sometimes parents tend to push their children to study things they don't want to study. So that can also backfire on your relationship. So I guess what's better is to help your son or daughter find their interests. And instead, like, it may turn out that they end up studying what you want them to study. Like, for example, I never felt any pressure from my parents to study, I guess, math and science, but it just turns out that my dad was really into that stuff when he was in college, but he doesn't do that for an occupation now. But it turns out that I happen to have the same interests as him, so that turned out fine for our family. And you never know, it may turn out fine for your family too. Okay. I'm done. Thank you.
Amanda， 我想能不能请教一个问题？你 time management 刚才你有很多活动讲的，分享的很好。那个，我能不能请教你有没有参加过 science fair？
Science fair， not the local science fair， but
okay.
I've done like competitions where you send in your research。
那个 Amanda， 你的那个 Intel 奖哈，我觉得很，我们前面提过很不容易哈。
Okay.
那个西门子奖也很难。您能讲的 difference 就是这个 Intel 和西门子奖的 ，what's the difference？
Siemens is solely based on your research, so Intel also has the component where you send in teacher recs and transcripts, and it's basically just another college application, Intel, and Siemens is just like a part of that.It's solely based on your research.
Okay, 那你刚才说那个，西门子像一个 college application 哈。
Intel.
Intel.、
Yeah.
Okay. 那请问这个 Intel 的这个， 整个这个申请的过程中有没有人帮助你？
My professor, the professor that I did research with, but other than that, you have to write a lot of essays for Intel, and I guess when you're writing those essays, if you're applying for Intel, you should just keep in mind that focus on your research, don't like draw too big of a big picture. Yeah.
你的这些 essay 有人帮你吗？
No, I wrote them myself.
Okay.
I stayed up late.
我知道你。
Don't do that.
Okay, 我知道那个 Amanda 其实现在已经，她不是 early 录取哈，她是已经被那个 Yale, Columbia and 还有 Berkeley 录取了。
Okay.
还有哪一个吗？
Well, yeah.
对，她因为她这个是因为我们知道通常录取都是四月一号哈。他现在还是在二月份的时候他已经接受了这么多通知，那我想你的 college application 已经写得非常好，请问你的 essay 你的 application 是你是有人帮助你写的还是你自己写的？
I wrote them and they took a long 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 time, so start early.
Okay, start early. 那你是要你有 counselor 帮你吗？你是自己写的吗还是别人帮你写的？
My school counselor helped a bit, but that's it. Like,In the end, your counselor can only help you so much because if your counselor helps you, write an essay that's not yours, then that doesn't usually turn out well.
Okay, 所以我们大家听到了哈，其实很多我没有我刚才问他的这些问题，因为我们要准备这个电脑哈，所以我临时问的问题也是跟他事先没有准备过的哈。我不是告诉大家说 counselor 外边那种 private 的 counselor 就不重要哈。只是我想从他这里例子就知道其实孩子自己也能做得到，但是要能够做到的话孩子自己要很用心，因为他的事情真的很多，自己参加那么多比赛，还有我没有提到的 Amanda 他是USPO 两年的 AMI 五年，对不对？
Okay.
他也是数学上就是花了很多的时间的功夫做这么多的事情哈， time management 也是非常重要的，但是他这个对大学申请这方面他也是很用心，所以如果大家用心的去了解，他的妈妈也是非常了不起，我们提到他们家四个，他是老二，他下面还有两个，他下面两个呢跟他离得也很近，一个八年级一个十年级，他十二年级，但 everything 他妈妈非常用心的去了解，用心的就知道说我孩子该选什么课，学校公立学校的课不够，他们 Sutter High School 学校不够我怎么办，我该让孩子到 Community College 修课还是到哪个 Learning Center 去修课，我知道他们修的一些课他们也去 Learning Center 修课，但他们修的课不是说这个我不知道，好想问你有没有做过 preview 的课？
Preview, a long time ago when I was in I previewed chem before freshman year, but I didn't even take chem in freshman year, so it was like it wasn't so much of a preview as like